In this video tutorial, you will learn how to create a similar scene to this using Blender 3D software, which is free, and do some basic compositing using After Effects just to give a little bit of extra effects, such as steam rising from this cup or a teapot. And this tutorial will be divided in a couple videos, so I really try to make it an easy to follow tutorial. Also, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. I will make sure to answer all of them. First of all, download Blender 4.1 or any newer version and install it into your computer. And then just download Blenderkit add-on that we will be using during this tutorial. It's a very useful add-on because it has over 26,000 of assets free to use, with a possibility to upgrade to even to have an access to even more amazing 3D assets, as you can see, around 50,000. So to download this add-on, you can find a link in the description. So just download it, and with installation process, I will guide you later on. Okay, first of all, let's install add-on, edit references, add-ons. Press install and find a zip file of Blenderkit. And just install it later. Make sure it's enabled. And if you purchase the license, just make sure to log in. And then just save preferences. So now let's add a cube. Let's move up a little bit. Just some dimensions, nothing specific really. Edit mode, select faces, this wall and the ceiling, X, delete faces. And I like to separate the floor as well, right click, separate selection. Go back to object mode, and while both of them are selected, grab. Let's move a little bit just above the grid, just like that. Make sure to save it, save as. Now let's use our add-on, so make sure to press free first if you haven't got the license. And let's look for a chimney. And just press to download it. Rotate Z axis and put 90. Grab X and let's push it against the wall. If you press a dot on a numpad key, you will focus on the object. Okay, let's add some logs around. By holding shift and right click, we will place the cursor where we want to download assets. Okay, so let's add some logs over here, perhaps over there as well. So let's adjust the scale because obviously it is way too big. Press S to scale. Let's rotate the z-axis a little bit, perhaps like that. Let's take this one, let's add closer to the chimney. Doesn't have to be perfect, you can always adjust it later. Make sure to save it on a regular basis, Ctrl+S. How about we place a camera right now? Shift+A, camera. Let's grab it and Z to move up. Let's grab it, let's move backwards and X axis. And by pressing here, we go to the camera mode. Then in this menu, let's go to view, camera to view. So we can move freely the camera. Also, we can add some guides so we can place the camera exactly in the center. So we just go, we click on a camera over here, camera data, viewport display, composition guides, and center. So, you know, it helps to center the shot. For the moment, it's good for me. Let's uncheck camera to view. I definitely want to adjust the scale of these objects. Okay, let's add a stool. Something that can fit a cozy cabin vibe. Perhaps an X. How about a kettle? Now this one looks pretty cool. Dusty and old, just to complement the view. Let's add the table in the middle. I like this one. For me, it's a little bit too big, so I press S to scale it in Z axis. Let's crush it like this, just so it's not that tall. Let's go to camera view. And let's adjust maybe the scale in Y axis. Okay, now this is a good moment for us to adjust the camera. I think I will zoom in more. Now we can place some cups on the table, some plates with cookies and cakes, and just let your imagination go wild. My apologies, but I had to turn off here the add-on that was showing every single click I was making. Unfortunately, because of it, my Blender was crashing all the time I was recording this video. So now let's add some cookies. Over there, let's add the book. Open book.